Let's see if we can apply what we know about negative numbers and what we know about exponents to apply exponents to negative numbers. So let's first think about, let's say we have negative 3. Let's first think about what it means to raise it to the first power. Well, that literally means just taking a negative 3. Just taking a negative 3, and there's nothing left to multiply it with. So this is just going to be equal to negative 3. Now what happens if we were to take negative 3? And we were to raise it to the second power. Well, that's equivalent to taking two negative 3s, so a negative 3 and a negative 3, and then multiplying them together. And what's that going to be? Well, a negative times a negative is a positive. So that is going to be positive 9. Let me write, this is going to be positive 9. But let's keep going. Let's see if there's some type of a pattern here. Let's take negative 3 and raise it to the third power. What is this going to be equal to? Well, we're going to take 3 negative 3s, 1, 2, and 3, and we're going to multiply them together. Negative 3 times negative 3, we already figured out, is positive 9. But positive 9 times negative 3, well, that's negative 27. And so you might notice a pattern here. Whenever we raised a negative base, so we raise a negative base to an exponent, if we raise it to an odd exponent, we are going to get a negative value. And that's because when you multiply it an even number of times, the negatives, a negative times a negative is a positive, and then you have one more negative to multiply it by, which makes it negative. And if you take a negative base, and you raise it to an even power, that's because you're always, if you multiply a negative times a negative, you're going to get a positive. And then you're doing, so when you do it an even number of times, you're doing a multiple of two number of times. So the negatives and the negatives all cancel out, I guess you could say. Or they, when you take the product of the two negatives, you keep getting positives. So this is going to be, this right over here is going to give you a positive value. So there's really nothing new about multiplying or taking powers of negative numbers. It's really the same idea, and you just really have to remember that a negative times a negative is a positive, and a negative times a positive is a negative, which we already learned from multiplying negative numbers. Now there's one other thing that I want to clarify, because sometimes there might be ambiguity if someone writes, let's say someone writes that. I encourage you to actually pause the video and think about what this right over here would evaluate to. And if you've given a go at that, think about whether this should mean something different than that. Well, this one can be a little bit ambiguous, and if people are strict about order of operations, you should really be thinking about the exponent before you multiply by this negative 1. This is implicitly saying negative 1 times 2 to the third power. So many times, this will usually be interpreted as negative 2 to the third power, which is equal to negative 8, while this is going to be interpreted as negative 2 to the third power. Now that also is equal to negative 8, and you might say, well, what's the big deal here? Well, what if these were even exponents? So what if someone had, let me give myself some more space here, what if someone had these two expressions, negative 4, or a negative 4 squared, or negative 4 squared? This one clearly evaluates to 16, positive 16. It's a negative 4 times a negative 4. This one could be interpreted as, especially if you look at order of operations and you do your exponent first, this would be interpreted as negative 4 times 4, which would be negative 16. So it's really important to think about this properly. And if you want to write the number negative, if you want the base to be negative 4, put parentheses around it and then write the exponent.